Sean Spicer is doing battle with reporters today over so-called fake news. Back with me now, my panel, and joining us is CNN political commentator Alice Soot. Alice, help, because Jack is trying to hog the entire panel. And we're talking about, listen, the language and what happened today.
I'm getting ganged up on.
No, you're not. You're just saying crazy things.
I don't believe that.
You're not being ganged up on. You're sometimes defending the indefensible. But I want to talk about Hope Hicks, who put out this story, put out this response today, said, President Trump, let me tell you what it's about. The Washington Post recently ran a story titled, Snubs and Slights Are Part of the Job in Trump's White House. And then White House spokeswoman Hope Hicks pushed back on the report. Here's a statement. President Trump has a magnetic personality and exudes positive energy, which is infectious to those around him. He has an unparalleled ability to communicate with people, whether he is speaking to a room of three or an arena of 30,000. He has built great relationships throughout his life and treats everyone with respect. He is brilliant with a great sense of humor and his amazing ability to make people feel special and aspire to be more than even they thought possible.
Bravo. I want Hope Hicks to write my eulogy right now. I actually thought that was a headline.
I thought that was a story from an Onion, when I read it. I mean, come on, Alice.
Yeah. You thought maybe she was talking about you, Don.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah, Hope Hicks didn't write it. Donald Trump wrote it.
Hey, Don. Don.
Alice. Name is Alice, not Jack. Go ahead, Alice.
Okay.
Now, obviously, you're gonna say favorable things about your boss, and anyone on that team, they're there to support him, put him in his best light. When there's a story like this out there, obviously, you're going to put out a statement that shows him in the best light. And I applaud her for doing her job. I'm sure a lot of folks could pick that apart very
well. For a spokesperson to put out about anyone, I mean, any boss, you would say, listen, I don't always agree with my boss, but he's great at this or whatever, and sometimes misunderstood, blah, blah, blah. But no one goes on to say he has a magnetic personality. And come on. Come on, Alice.
Yeah, anyone in a communications position doesn't put a clarifier on a statement like that. You put it out there and let the statement speak for itself. That's just how it works.
Okay, so Jason, let's talk about more about what's coming out of people's mouths at the White House. Spicer got into a heated argument with reporters after failing to come up with a sturdy example of fake news.
I think he's very pleased with the work of his staff. I think that he is frustrated, like I am and like so many others, to see stories come out that are patently false, to see narratives that are wrong, to see quote unquote fake news. When you see stories get perpetrated that are absolutely false, that are not based in fact, that is troubling. And he's rightly concerned.
Can you give an example of fake news, Sean?
Yeah, absolutely, Jim. I'll give you an example.
Please.
Sure. Friday, the president was having a great discussion at the G7, and someone from the BBC and ultimately an incoming reporter from the New York Times retweeted that the president was being rude by disrespecting the Italian prime minister. And when in fact, you all in every one of the meetings that we sit in watch the president with that one earpiece that's been used by other presidents, and yet the president did a great job at NATO. Building stronger bonds at the G7, increasing America's presence around the world. And that's the kind of thing that the BBC and ultimately the reporter who's now joining the New York Times push out and perpetuate with no apology. What, you're shaking your head, Peter. I mean, it's true, you did it. No, and I'm answering Jim's, but that's just fake.
Jason, was that an example of so-called fake news?
No, I'll give you a couple of examples of fake news. How about when the President of the United States said that 3 to 5 million folks voted illegally in the election, or when he claimed that the former president wiretapped him in Trump Tower? We could go through his greatest hits. The biggest problem with this is that when every single day, no matter what happens in the news, the President of the United States and the people who work for him say things that are patently untrue, when that happens, it is not just a credibility problem for the United States. And what that means is that when this president at some point has to tell the American people something that is very important for us to know for our safety, for our security, what happens when a lot of people, even people maybe who voted for him, mm-hmm. don't believe him? Yeah. It puts us in danger, and it puts us in danger when other countries can't believe it.
Jennifer, I have 30 seconds left here. Do you feel like this president is writing his own press releases now? That cannot be good for
the
country.
No, I really do. I really think that he is. Those scripts that you heard from both Hope Hicks and Sean Spicer, it's very clear that that's coming from the president himself. No staff person would ever do it because you understand it's destructive and counterproductive. And, you know, I really agree with what Jason said. I think of everything that I'm concerned about with the Trump presidency, the fact that the world and the United States, that Americans can't rely on the president of the United States to tell the truth and can't take him at his word is a very destructive and scary things. And, you know, you saw with like Merkel, what Merkel said this weekend that, you know, the Russian,
Don,
or that Europe and America can't rely on us.
What about the story that, what about this fake news story that Comey had asked for more money for the investigation? Not true at all. What about the story about Rosenstein that he said he was going to resign? Not true at all. What about the story about the Martin Luther King bus that was moved out of the Oval Office?
You're talking about stories. Those weren't stories. And you don't know if any of those are true or not.
Those were not stories put out
to intentionally deceive someone. That is what fake news is. It's not stories that you disagree
with, or sometimes
when reporters or news organizations make a mistake and then clarify or say they were wrong. That's not fake news. That's the way the world works. Are you always perfect? Do you always say the right thing? Do you always speak? Do you always know the exact answer?
There's absolutely fake news.
You didn't answer my question, Jack. Jack, are you perfect?
I absolutely am not.
Okay, then no one is, and no organization is.
Like you,
I've got to go.
But Don,
we'll be right back.
Don,